Hey artists, welcome to another video. Today is going to be the first day of a project that is probably gonna have me screaming why by the end of this, but hey, it's a project I've been wanting to do for a while, and now's a great time to start. So I'm calling this my 30 paintings in 30 days challenge, and that is exactly as it sounds. I'm hoping for the month of December, and I know December is 31 days, but we're just gonna round it up and call it 30. For the month of December, I am going to try to basically create enough paintings to match the days. Now, normally, people would do this as a one painting per day sort of challenge. But because I work with oils, and especially since I don't really work in an alla prima style, I let my painting dry in between and then do multiple layers with glazes, it's kinda hard to do one painting per day, at least if you're gonna be totally finishing a painting in between. So that's why I kind of changed my challenge a little bit. So instead of, you know, one painting a day for 30 days straight, I am going to aim to complete 30 small paintings within 30 days. And this means that I am going to be working on more than one painting per day. And that's okay. I kind of felt like I was cheating the challenge a little bit at first, but you know what? This is my challenge. I make the rules and those are what my rules are gonna be. So yeah, 30 paintings in 30 days. And my plan is to film myself painting for each of those days and upload them, hopefully, every day. And if it starts to become a little overwhelming, I might put 3 paintings to one video, but you know what we're gonna try this. So what I'm doing is I basically chose 10 different animals, and I'm going to be doing 3 paintings of each. And I decided to choose a really limited color palette here too. It's one of my favorite color palettes. It's very heavy on the purples and warm tones. So basically right now all I'm using is burnt umber, titanium white. I'm going to be using cobalt violet, and burnt sienna is going to add a really nice warmth to things. And basically, that's kind of the color palette I want to stick with. And I am going to be playing a lot with this challenge. Pushing my colors, pushing my just style in general. I want to see where I can take this. And ultimately, I want to use it as a lesson as getting better at color mixing, if that makes sense. And also seeing how far I can push things with glazes. So that's kind of the reason why I can't really do, you know, one painting per day, is because of my glazes. And my painting needs to be completely dry underneath before I can glaze. And sometimes it takes a couple of days. So that's a little bit of motive behind what I'm gonna be doing for this challenge. So one of my animal subjects out of the 10 that I chose is a Sphynx cat. I absolutely adore these hairless little alien babies. I think they're so beautiful and wrinkly and cute, and they always look angry, and oh, I love them. So I figured this was an appropriate way to kick it off. So as you can see here, I kind of did complete my main painting and I let it sit for a few days so it can dry. And now I'm going in with glazes. So I did want to push the colors a lot. I found that my underpainting was very monochromatic, which is fine. That's normally the way I like to work. And then I'm using glazes to really amp up the color. So I really want my shadows to be more purple in tone, making those highlights a little bit more on the cold side. So having a brighter cold white, adding a little warmth here and there, and just pushing things, letting this be an exploration and really a journey. I'm kind of game for this being a long journey. And you know what? If I'm gonna be struggling a little bit, then at least I wanna have fun along the way and make things a little more, you know, chaotic and fun. So this is the completed version of my first painting. I painted this on a piece of canvas sheet, so I taped it to a board. And normally this stage is about, you know, revealing those nice crisp lines, but because I'm not using actual painter's tape, I'm just using masking tape because my painter's tape is bright green and very ugly. I didn't get those super crisp lines I was looking for. So lesson learned, invest in some painter's tape that, you know, isn't a horrible obnoxious green that throws off your entire painting. But yeah, so hopefully you enjoyed the very first painting in this 30 paintings in 30 days challenge. I will see you tomorrow with our next animal subject.